الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، اللهم علمنا ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا، اللهم لك التعليم الحكيم. So we are in section 8.2 homogeneous systems, and we said that in order to solve homogeneous system we have to find the eigenvalues and the eigenvectors, and we divided this section into three cases. The first case we covered yesterday was the case of distinct real eigenvalues. So if you have a distinct eigenvalues lambda 1, lambda 2 of the lambda n, and for each eigenvalue we'll find the corresponding eigenvector, then the general solution looks like this: c1 k1 e lambda 1 t plus c2 k2 e lambda 2 t and so on. We take the linear combination of these eigenvector times exponential of the eigenvalue times t. Okay, so we take this linear combination. And we solve two examples. We solve two examples. One, when you have a system of two equations, two unknown, and here you have a system of three equations. We did it. Today we're going to talk about the repeated eigenvalues. What we will do if I had a repeated eigenvalues. So let's agree on the word multiplicity. Repeated eigenvalue usually comes from this factor, lambda minus a number, lambda 1, let's call it, to power n. Okay, so when you see the power n, that means you have a multiplicity of n. Actually, they call it algebraic multiplicity. Actually, it has a name, algebraic geometric multiplicity, but we don't want to go details to this. But for this, we handle two cases, because we have scenarios for the repeated eigenvalue. Okay? It's not like the equations. Here we have scenarios for this. Sometimes you have an eigenvalue lambda of multiplicity m, but when you try to calculate the eigenvectors, you will find exactly m eigenvectors. We will see in this an example. So for example, multiplicity 2, you will find two eigenvectors. Multiplicity 3, you will find three eigenvectors automatically, corresponding to that eigenvalue. And in this case, you will write the general solution like if it is a distinct eigenvalue, except that you will keep lambda all everywhere. But here you're going to say C1, K1, E lambda T, C2, K2, E lambda T. You can take E lambda T as a common factor, and you take the linear combination of the eigenvectors. Okay? So this is case one. The second case that we will cover in this section is that you will have an eigenvalue for multiplicity M, but unfortunately it will have only one eigenvector. Then the solutions will be look like, for example, it will be multiplicity 2, and you have only, when you calculate the eigenvectors, you get only one. Multiplicity 3, you will get only one eigenvector. Multiplicity, inshallah, 1 million, you get only one eigenvector. So the solution in this case will look like this. X1, the first solution, X1 equal K11 E lambda T. There is some vector, this is the eigenvector actually that you will take. K11 is the eigenvector, E lambda T. X2 will be K21T E lambda T plus K22 E lambda T. The K22 actually will be, we will show how to calculate this. And so on. X3 up to XM. So we keep in mind that if it is multiplicity M, that means I must have M solutions. So these are the M solutions. Okay, the M solution, the last one, this is a general formula. In this course, we'll cover up to X3. Up to X3 only. After that, you have a formula which will be just a matter of calculations. And of course, K21, K232, all of these K's, we will show later how to calculate them. Actually, after Eid, after the vacation, we'll show you how to calculate them. And then the general solution will be the linear combination C1, X1 plus C2, X2 up to CM, XM. For today, or for the moment, we're going to take, if lambda has multiplicity m and it has exactly m linearly independent eigenvectors, okay, and the solution will look like this. And let's have an example. So here we have. The example here, you have a system, x prime, I can write it like this, x prime equal, if you look at these equations, it will be 3, 1, 1. Minus 1, 1, minus 1, and then minus 1, minus 1, 1 times x. Okay? So this is the the system that we want to solve. طيب, you know that first we'll define the eigen values of A. This is A, okay? You know that how to find eigenvalues? You say that we will calculate the determinant of A minus lambda I equals to zero. That means you remember, Shabab, that we said when we focus on the diagonal, we said minus lambda, minus lambda, minus lambda. So we're going to say 3 minus lambda. And then 1, 1. Minus 1. Here I will say 1 minus lambda. Minus 1. And then minus 1. Minus 1. 1 minus lambda. I'll calculate the determinant and I'll make it equals to 0. طيب. I will leave this to you and check that the eigenvalues are lambda 1 equals 1 and lambda 2 and lambda 3 equals 2. There are a few calculations, but I will leave it to you because we did it twice actually. Basically, you will take the determinant and then you will get a polynomial of third degree and then you try to factor, so you will get this. طيب, شباب. طيب, by the way, yeah, you got something like this. Huh? Let me just make it for you. You got something like this equals to 0. Okay? So this is a multiplicity 1, this is a multiplicity 2. You see? This is the case of repeating. طيب, now what we will do. You will take one by one. So let's take this eigenvalue. So 4 lambda 1 equal 1. Remember, we solved this. A minus lambda I k equals to the 0 vector. So we said that, well, I will come to this original matrix. I will substitute every lambda by 1. So here 3 minus 1 will be 2, 1, 1. Minus 1. 1 minus what? It will be 0. Minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, 1 minus 1 will be 0. And then you have 0, 0, 0. And then you have to work with this matrix. You have to make it in echelon form. So first thing, let's swap these two rows. Instead of dividing by 2, it's better to replace R2 by R1. So you have 1, 0, negative 1, 0. 2, negative 1, negative 1, 0. 1, negative 1, 0. The next step. This is the one, try to make below it zero. So we're going to say minus 2 R1 plus R2, and then minus R1 plus R3. I can perform two row operations at the same time because you are affecting only these two rows. You're not affecting in the same row. So now the first row stays the same. The second row, you will say minus 2 plus 2 will be zero. Multiply minus 2 to zero, and then add to this will be negative 1. And then you multiply. I'm sorry about that. Okay. And then multiply negative 2 to negative 1, so you get 2 plus minus 1, so you get 1. And then you multiply negative 1. Now I'm reading this operation. Minus 1 R1, that means multiply to this negative 1 plus 1, you get 0. Negative 1 times 0 minus 1. Okay. So now. And then negative 1, 1, plus 1, or plus 0, you get 1. So you get this. Now we see two rows are identical here, okay? So now, what you will do, you can cancel one of these rows. So we can say minus R2 plus R3. So you get 1, 0, negative 1, 0. 0, negative 1, 1. And then it's basically you're going to say multiply minus and add to this, so you get 0. Multiple minus 1 to 1 and add this 0, so you get 0. Okay, so now I got this, the last four, the simplest four of the matrix. And then what will be the equations, this one? In terms of K1, K2, K3, what will be the equations here? Yes, Tahir?
K1 minus K3 equals 0.
Equals 0, very good. And then?
Minus K2 plus K3 equals 0.
Equals 0. Mumtaz, mumtaz. So now, then you got K1 equals K3, and K2 equals K3. And K3 is arbitrary. Arbitrary constant. So what we will do, you can choose a value for K3, any value you want, and to make it easy to ourselves, let's choose it one. Okay, so let K3 equals 1, then K1 is equal 1, and K2 is equal 1. So the vector K1, which is 1, 1, 1, is why 1, 1? Because this is K1, K2, K3, yeah? So I substitute their values. So is an eigen vector corresponding to the eigen value lambda 1 equals 1. Okay. But now let's work with the other eigenvalue. Okay. And who are 2. Okay. So let's work with it. Okay. So for lambda 2 or lambda 3 equals 2, the repeated one, the repeated one. What will happen? Well, we will solve this a minus lambda I k equals to 0. So we will do the same thing. I will substitute every lambda by 2. So 3 minus 2 will be 1, 1, 1, minus 1. 1 minus 2, you get minus 1, minus 1. And then you get minus 1, minus 1. 1 minus 2, you get minus 1, 0, 0, 0. But look, Shabab, what I got. I got here, the three rows are the same thing. Huh? The three rows are the same thing. So I can say minus R1 plus R2. I can make this second row zeros. Also, I can make the third one to be zeros. So get 1 minus 1 minus 1, 0. 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. Huh? All of these will automatically will be zeros. And hence, the resulting equation will be k1 minus k2 minus k3 will be 0, which means that k1 is equal k2 plus k3. If you look at this equation, or even this one, you see you have only one equation. In three unknowns, 1, 2, 3, you have three unknowns, and you have only one equation. So what does it mean? It means that two of them must be arbitrary. Two of them must be arbitrary. So let's say K2 and K3 are arbitrary constants. Because you can solve this equation in this way. You have two of them are arbitrary constants. So you can choose any values for K2 and K3. You can choose any two numbers for them. So for example, I will choose K2 to be 0, K3 to be 1. Then K1 will be 0 plus 1, which is 1. You can also choose another values, K2 equal 1 and K3 equal, for example, 0. Then K1 is equal 1 plus 0, which is 1. So the vectors K2, which is equal 2. Now K2, I will move here. This is 0, this is 1, and the K1 is 1. And the vector K3. Here will be 1 in the middle, down will be 0, and here 1, are eigenvectors corresponding to the eigen value lambda 2 equals 2, and lambda 3 also, 2 and 3 equals 2. طيب, look at these two are linearly independent. You know, ما تقدر تقول والله one of, you cannot say one of them is a multiple constant of the other. You don't have a constant, you multiply here to get this, and vice versa. Right? So you have two linearly independent eigenvectors. And this situation happened because this. Okay? Because of this. Fine. Now let's write the general solution. And the general solution will be, let me show you the slide because it's written there. You write C1 K1 E lambda T plus C2 K2 E lambda T plus C3 K3 E lambda T. And notice for this repeated eigenvalue, I get two eigenvectors. Multiplicity 2, I get two eigenvectors. So I am okay with it. So I can write it using as if it is a distinct eigenvalue. Okay. That's why you seen this. In addition to what we found in the previous paper, OK? okay, اللي هو تذكرون ال K1. This is the K1. Okay, 1 1 1. This is what we do. This is for the case if you have repeated multiplicity 2, but you get 2 eigenvalues. طيب, now, let's talk about the case if you have an eigenvalue with only one eigenvector, but with multiplicity 2. Okay, and after the vacation, inshallah, we're going to take the multiplicity 3, what we will do. Okay, now let's assume that if lambda 1 is an eigenvalue of multiplicity 2, and there is only one eigenvector associated with this value, then the first solution is this. No problem with it. Because you get only one eigenvector, let's call it K. This is what it looks like. The second solution, it takes this form. KT e lambda 1t plus P e lambda 1t, where the K is this. And there is a vector B, a new vector. They call it generalized eigenvector, actually. And the vector B can be found by solving this system or this matrix equation. Okay? And look, it is really similar to the K. How we obtain the K? We put K equal to 0. Huh? I mean, just to make it this A minus lambda I K to the current eigenvector. But look what is the difference. Here K, we will call it B. Here 0, now here is a different. Here I will put the K. يعني ال eigenvector K will be an ingredient in finding the B, in cooking the vector B. Huh? طيب. So let's take an example. Now I have here, it is already written in the matrix form, x prime equal 3, 2, minus 18, minus 9, x. Okay. طبعا, the first step will be h. First, find the eigenvalue of A. So we'll say the determinant of A minus lambda I equals to 0, which implies that we're going to say 3 minus lambda 2 minus 18 minus I minus lambda equals to 0. طبعا, you will do these calculations, and you will find that lambda plus 3 square equals to 0, which means that lambda 1 equals lambda 2 equals negative 3. Okay, I will leave these calculations for you. Because it's not finding eigenvalue is not a problem. It's about the eigenvectors. Now for lambda 1, which is equal lambda 2, which is equal negative 3, okay, if I get two eigenvectors, that's okay. I will write it as if it is distinct eigenvalues. If I got only one eigenvector, then I have to do something to find the P. Okay. So this is the equation that we want to solve. Okay, to obtain the eigenvectors. So we said, well, replace every lambda by the eigenvector that you're working with. So 3 minus minus 3, so becomes 6. 2 minus 9 plus 3, so you get minus 6. 0, 0. Well, you will divide by 6 for the R1, so you get 1, negative 3, 0. 2, negative 6, 0. And then you're going to say minus 2 R1 plus R2. So we get 1, negative 3 is 0. And here when we say minus 2 plus 2, we get 0. Minus 2 times 3, we get 6. Minus 6, we get 0. So this implies that K1 minus 3 K2 equals 0. Or you can say K1 equals 3 K2. And of course, K2, you can let it to be arbitrary. You can make K1 arbitrary, by the way. Huh? I keep saying this. You need to follow this. You can make K2 equals 1/3 of K1. That's fine. Right. And K1, you can make it arbitrary. So here you can say let K2 equals 1, then K1 will be equal 3, and hence the vector K1, so K2 is 1, K1 is 3, is an eigen vector corresponding to the eigen value lambda 1 equal negative 3 or lambda 2 if you want. Okay. طيب الآن I'm in shortage of vectors. I have only one vector. So that means I got one solution. Huh? Solution حيكون كده شكلها. X1 equals C1 K1 E minus 3T. But I am in shortage of solutions because I have a system of two equations. That means I must find the other solution. The other solution, in order to write it, I have to find the vector P. The vector P. By the way, this is analogous to the idea of reduction of order, if you remember. يعني you have one solution, you have shortage, so we have to find the other solution. So we need to find the vector P. طب ال P من فين راح تيجي يشبه؟ We solve the equation, the matrix equation actually, or the system. A minus lambda I P equals K, okay, or K1 if you want. طبعا P, let's call the entries of P, P1 and P2. Huh? طيب, so what basically what you are doing here? A minus lambda I, it is this, this guy. So it will be like this, 6, 2, minus 18, minus 6. But we are saying equal, here it was equal to 0, that's why we are writing 0, 0. Now here we are saying equal to K1. What is K1? It is this, the one you early calculated. So I put here 3 and 1, okay? The P, what will happen? طبعا P, it is, that's why you're putting vertical bar. يعني خلاص, the P will be embedded here in the calculations. طيب يا شباب. Now let's do row operations. And you can do the same row operations. You say, for example, 1 over 6 R1. So you have 1, negative 3. But here I have to be careful. Now when I divide by 6, you get half. 2, negative 3, 2, negative 6 and 1. And then you're going to say what? You're going to say, let's do it here down. Minus 2 R1 plus R2. So you get 1, negative 3, half. Now minus 2 plus 2, you get 0. Minus 2 times negative 3 will be 6. Minus 6 will be 0. Minus 2 times half, you get minus 1 and 1, you get 0. طيب. This implies what? This implies that P1, طبعا حطوا بالكم انه قاعد تضرب في P1 P2 ايش هذا؟ So P1 minus 3 P2 equals to half. Or you can say P1 equals 3 P2 plus half. Where P2 is arbitrary. طيب. Now what you can let P2 any value you want. But I can make it zero. Why? Because P1 will becomes half. So I am sure that I will get the vector half and zero. I mean, it's not a zero vector. If I get zero, zero, that will be a problem. I'm not going to take the zero vector. Here, I'm sure that this vector will be non-zero. طيب يا شباب. And then what? And then I will substitute in the formula of the solution for this case. Okay. So. Okay, here, yes. So the formula says this. Oh, sorry. Okay, let me do it in the left. Yes. Yeah. It says C1 K E negative 3T, which is this one. The K we already calculated. Yeah, E1. It happened that I'm choosing the same thing. Now, C2, you have this expression. K, 3, 1, T. Many students, they forget T. There is T here. T E negative 3T plus this is the vector P that we did it here. I made a choice. I get half and zero. But you can make any choice. You can take P2 equal 1, for example. So you get 3 plus half. So you get 7 over 2. Huh? 7 over 2 and 1. You can have it this way. Okay. So there are many forms of answers, actually, for this. Right? And then this will be your general solution. Yeah. Inshallah, after the vacation, we're going to take if it is multiplicity 3. We're going to have a formula like this. Okay. This is the end of today's lecture. And inshallah,